So good morning, standard 10 students. Now I am going to explain what took place or what happened when Tubal had returned from Genoa. Now we heard this name Tubal earlier, because when Antonio and Bassanio wanted help, they approached Shylock, and then Shylock said that I am trying to recollect whether I have that amount of money, but no problem, I will consult another friend of mine, Tubal. He will furnish me with all the money which if I run short. So Tubal is another Jew, maybe he is also a money lender and a close friend to Shylock. Now since Jessica had run away, so he had asked his friend Tubal to help him. Okay. So Tubal returns back. Shylock, how now, Tubal? What news from Genoa has thou found my daughter? So he says, you have just come from Genoa. Did you find my daughter? Tubal, I often came where I did hear of her. He says, wherever I heard, wherever she was, I immediately would rush to that spot, but cannot find her. Unfortunately, I was not able to find her. Now Shylock says, why there, a diamond gone. Now, Tubal was not able to find his daughter, so he says, there, a diamond gone. That means if he is not able to get his daughter, that means he will not be able to recover whatever she has stolen from him. Ducats, jewelry and precious stones. So when he cannot find her, it means he cannot find or recover his lost wealth. The curse never fell upon our nation till now. So he considers this act of Jessica to be a curse, where an intercaste marriage, a Jewish girl runs away with a Christian boy. So he says this kind of a curse is the first that has ever happened in the history of the Jewish nation. I never felt it till now. 2,000 ducats in that. Says, I never felt it so much. In other words, it means I don't feel much about my daughter as much as I feel the value of the money. He says, now when he talks about the diamond, he says it is, he paid 2,000 ducats in that and other precious jewels. Means since he cannot find his daughter, so now he is feeling sad about how he cannot recover whatever she has taken from him. Now the anger is so much. So when a father is betrayed by his own daughter, he wishes, he says, I would my daughter were dead at my foot. He says, I wish that my daughter was lying dead in front of me. And the jewels in her ears, would she were hearsed at my foot, and the ducats in her coffin. Now he's trying to picturize that he wished that his daughter was lying dead in front of him and in a coffin and on the hearse. The hearse is the cart in which carries the dead body, okay, to the grave. So he's imagining his daughter dead and all the money in the coffin and all the precious stones or jewelry that she has. Now could you imagine how angry Shylock was to know that, see what his daughter has done. So a request to all the young boys and girls, when you fall in love, Be bold and inform your parents. Don't rob them and betray them. Speak to them. See if they understand your problem. But don't commit or do such drastic things that would not only offend you, will offend everyone. Don't only think about yourself. Be more considerate about your parents who have sacrificed a lot to bring you up to this level. So my request is, don't betray them. Okay. No news of them. Why so? And I know not what's spent in the search. So till now there is no results. So I know exactly how much money I am spending to search her, to find her. And there is no output. Why? So I know not what's spent in the search. Why thou loss upon loss? The thief gone with so much. So now there is a double loss he is complaining about. One is that he is spending so much of money to find his daughter. And his daughter herself, she has taken away all the money. So he considers his daughter, Jessica, a thief. So he says over here, the thief gone with so much. Means Jessica is considered the thief and she has taken away practically all his wealth. Okay, and so much to find the thief and no satisfaction. So, and so much of money I am spending to find the thief, mean to find my daughter, but the result is nil, with no satisfaction. So here he's complaining that although he is having a double loss, spending money to find his daughter, and his daughter also had robbed him of so much of money, and no results, mean they're not able to locate or find Jessica so that they could recover back the money she has taken. No revenge, no ill luck stirring, but what lights on my shoulders. Says, I am so desperate, I am so helpless, that I cannot even take revenge. It is only that I am being very upset. I am disillusioned. Okay. So I am so helpless that I cannot even do anything except no sighs but of my breathing. Now sigh means when we breathe. And then when a sigh of relief means, oh, thank God. So I can't even do that. I can only, what do you say, concentrate on my normal breathing. No tears, but of my shedding. He says, I can't even shed tears. I can't even cry. That means here he is expressing his helplessness. A rich man spending money to find his daughter, but is of no use. So he cannot even take out revenge. With whom will he take out revenge? With his own daughter? Now Tubal, as understood, he says, yes, other men have ill luck too. So you're not the only one who is having bad luck. There are other people as well in this world. And one of them is Antonio. I heard in Genoa. Because remember, he's just coming from Genoa. Now when he hears that Antonio is also undergoing some suffering or some pain. So Shylock, what ill luck, ill luck. Means he can't believe that a man like Antonio is also suffering with some bad luck. Something wrong has also taken place in his life. Tubal had an Agassiz cast away coming from Tripolis. So one of his ships coming from Tripolis had been shipwrecked. So that was the major loss of Antonio. Now that was a good piece of information, good news for Shylock. Now why it is considered good news? Because something wrong has taken place with his enemies. Now this is what we feel about the enemies. If anything good they do, it hurts us. It is very painful. We can't bear to see that person doing well in life. But what gives us utter satisfaction is when we know that my enemy is suffering. He is undergoing through tremendous loss or pain or suffering or misery. As much as ruination is taking place with my enemy, so much of satisfaction I get. I get overthrilled. So this is the way Shylock reacted. He is so extremely happy that Antonio has lost a ship which is coming from Tripoli. I thank God, I thank God. Is it true? Is it true? Now he wants to know. He wants to be confirmed what Tubal heard when he was returning from Genoa, whether it is true that Antonio's ship coming from Tripolis had been shipwrecked. Now he wants the proof. He wants the real confirmation of this piece of news. Tubal, I spoke with some of the sailors that escaped the wreck. So I was speaking to some of the sailors who were in that ship. So when that ship was getting wrecked or drowning, so they saved themselves. So they are the ones who confirmed, they are the proof that actually one of Antonio's ship has been wrecked. Shylock, I thank thee, good Tubal. Good news, good news. Ha 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 ha. Where in Genoa? Now remember, Genoa is the place where he had sent Tubal to find his daughter. Tubal is unable to find his daughter in Genoa, but giving him some bad news or good news about Antonio's ruination. And that makes Shylock feel very excited and happy. Then Tubal drops a bomb. Your daughter spent in Genoa, as I heard, in one night, 80 ducats. So in Genoa, there's another bad news. And what I heard, that your daughter Jessica has spent 80 ducats in one night. Now that news is so painful. This is a metaphor. He says, thou stickest a dagger in me. He says, you're giving me very sad and bad news. It is very painful. It is as painful as somebody sticking a dagger into me. I shall never see my gold again. Means, in other words, if my daughter is spending money lavishly, then I'm afraid I will not be able to get my gold and money back. 80 ducats at a sitting, 80 ducats. Says, my God, such a lot of money in one night, such a lot of money, unbelievable. Why? Because Shylock is a miser. He doesn't love to spend. So it hurts him when he hears somebody spending money. Okay. So I shall continue this in the next video class. Thank you.